Welcome to the Chef's Kitchen Restaurant Edition. I'm your host, Nicole Gaffney, and we're here today at Nordon Preferred Kitchen Equipment Studios. And joining us is Chef Tony Clark. Hey, Tom.
Hey, thanks for having me.
We always love having you here in the Chef's Kitchen.
You have a killer place here.
I know. Wow. This kitchen is really something.
You know, the only thing that's missing, me.
Well, we have you here.
Now, see?
The only thing that's missing is food. So what are we making
today? We have that
today?
Too. We're going to do a pasta primavera.
Okay.
A dish I've done a couple times. I really love it.
It's classic.
Classic.
Totally.
I like the way you said classic.
Yeah.
Okay, so we have all these vegetables, and
lots
we could probably
veg.
Use lots more if we mm-hmm. wanted to. But these are the ones that we're choosing today. So what I'm going to do is first is trim some of the vegetables and start to blanch them.
You do really have a lot.
Yeah, we have a lot. It's an army. So here's our blanching water.
All right.
We're going to cook it and then put it right in the pot and start a sauce with it. And this is our pasta water, which is not ready yet, but...
Are we salting either of the waters?
Yes.
Okay.
So we did season them a little bit, so we just check them.
Is it salt?
Needs a little bit more in there. Okay. And then we taste this one. All right, taste that.
There's none.
None, but, you know, so we got to be careful. So salt is important.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that's that. Okay, let's check that now. Now taste it. It's going to kick in about 5 minutes, and we'll check it before we put the pasta in there again.
Cool.
Okay. And this one is getting there. So we'll just put a little bit more.
And we can use our fingers because it's just going to boil right off, right?
Yeah. I love to cook with my hands.
I do too.
You know, that's...
Your best tool is your hand.
It's part of the passion.
Mm-hmm.
So I have these beautiful carrots. So I'm just going to peel them.
Do you always peel carrots?
Yes.
You have to?
No.
Easy enough.
I like the clean color of the carrot.
Yeah, it is such a nice color.
And the carrot I can make taste very good,
mm-hmm.
peeled or unpeeled. So.
All right. I bet. I believe that.
Thank you, dear.
I love you. Really, don't lose much of the color of the carrots when you cook them either, unlike other veg.
No, it's a great vegetable. So I'm just going to clean this up.
I'll take these.
Thank you, love. You're amazing.
I do what I can.
I know.
Now, would you utilize the carrot tops also?
Yes, I put them in a stock.
Nice.
I try not to waste anything.
I know.
Okay, so
I'm
this
great
cup
that way.
Is oblique. And you just turn the carrot a little bit. You can see that.
Ooh, excuse me. Neat.
Mm-hmm.
They get a lot bigger as you get up there.
So we don't want to... So we just cut these up like this, okay? And I'm gonna start with the vegetables that take a little longer
mm-hmm.
first. You know, so they're done, if I can give you
so
this.
So everything can kind of be done at the same time.
Right. So we're gonna turn this on.
Hey Tony, I heard you tried some of the new slicing machines that they have here. What do you think about those?
I love it. It's just amazing how things. I mean, the dice on the red onion impressed me.
Mm-hmm.
The slicing of the tomato impressed me. It was nice. It was really clean, really fast.
Cool.
I think I might fire about 3 guys now when I go home.
No, we don't want to see you do that. But they have great equipment here.
Okay. Now we have under there is a small strainer.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I'm going to put this carrot in there, and you just want to check the carrot to see if it's.
Babysit them.
You don't want to overcook them. You don't want to undercook them.
Al dente?
Perfect.
Got it.
Yeah, let's have...
And these will take a couple minutes, though, right? Okay.
So the next one is the fennel, the fennoik.
I love fennel.
Me too.
Fennoik?
Fennoik. Yeah.
Is that your Irish coming out?
No, that's my Italian friends telling me. Fennoik, you know, because I'm Irish, they figured I might not know what they're talking about. So we use this also with many things, but mm-hmm. I'm just looking for a cleaner look veg, okay?
It smells so nice and fresh.
Oh, I love fennel. Okay, so I'm going to just take the core off a little bit, just so it'll cook more evenly, because mm-hmm. the core is a little denser than the leaves.
All right.
Okay, so we're going to put them in there as well. So we have two things cooking different directions.
Okay. Got all kinds of stuff, broccoli, cauliflower.
Right. And then the zucchini and squash. So these all are pretty much the same, but this pepper might take a little longer.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Longer than the broccoli and cauliflower?
Sometimes. I like it soft.
Okay.
Okay. So this is a yellow pepper,
mm-hmm.
orange pepper. Now, it's a little sweeter than the red and the green.
Sweeter than the red?
A little blander in the sweet part, but mm-hmm. I mean, the red has a great flavor.
Yeah.
But this is very mild.
Okay.
Okay.
I like
it's
these.
Not aggressive. All right, so we're just going to clean these up and play with these a little bit. All right, so I'm just taking the pepper and removing some of the rib, so it's an even cut and an even cook.
I always wondered how chefs got pepper slices so even.
Yeah.
Because whenever I cut them at home, I leave all the rib in.
That's great.
Stay tuned for more from Nordon Preferred Kitchen Equipment.
Nordon, it's fantastic. There's a lot of space, high-tech equipment. The ovens are phenomenal. I can't wait to own one.
Okay, now we have the onion and a little garlic and shallots, which we'll add for the sauce.
Yeah, you're not gonna blanch these, right?
No.
Okay. One thing you do really well, Tony, is add a lot of flavor to everything.
That's why I have this beautiful physique of a body.
That's
created
from
by flavor.
From all the flavor.
Yeah. What diet are you on? Flavor diet.
Not a bad diet to be on, in my opinion.
Okay. So we take a little bit of the shallots, too.
You kind of get a little bit of that sweetness from the shallot and that more of a bite from the onion.
Right. And then we take a little garlic. How's it doing?
The smaller ones are definitely done,
okay,
so I'm gonna pull everything.
Yeah, put it all out.
And where am I putting
it? Right in the pan.
Right in the pan?
See how that's working? Awesome. Fabulous. So, we're gonna add a little salt. Nice. Pepper. We're gonna add more pepper later. Pepper and pasta, I love it.
Match made in heaven?
That's what it is. Now we put a little butter.
What type of pasta are we gonna use? A short or fat?
I you know, it was great that question that you asked, because I would usually use like a fettuccine, but.
Yeah.
The farfalle looked exciting to me today. It looked
I like the farfalle, little bow ties.
Yeah, little bow ties.
You can wear one.
Yeah, no, I can't.
Do you wanna put these peppers in?
Yep. So you're just going to keep an eye on this. I'm trying to keep it at a slow sweat.
All right. So we're not looking to get any color.
No color.
All right.
Okay, so I'm going to take this now. I'm going to just rinse these off. We're going to blanch this.
Throw them in right now?
Mm-hmm. And this. Now we have the zucchini and the squash.
Oh, sugar snap peas. I love these.
Yeah, me too. We're going to tourneau some zucchini.
Wow, you're going to tournay these?
It's a quick tournay. It's a, not a real tournay, but it's an imitation tournay. See, we're in the imitation world. Yeah? So we just kind of turn it like this, see?
Explain what a tournay is to the audience. So you're only doing three cuts,
You're turning
really.
The vegetable.
Okay.
You're turning the vegetable. Not turning the knife, you're turning the vegetable.
So you got
these
torpedoes.
And this comes
torpedoes.
From in the castles in Europe, and they had a little tournay on top of the castles all around. Mm-hmm. So that's some chef made it for a king.
Okay.
And he had tournées, and he loved this castle. And
so you're not even blanching these,
no.
You're just throwing them straight in.
Right.
And I think, should we pull these out to keep them on the crisp side, or?
Yeah, well, it's gonna cook a little bit more in the sauce. You're gonna put them right in there.
Okay.
Okay.
I love how nice and bright they turn
yeah,
when they
hit awesome.
The water.
Let's check this out. All right, that's good. We're gonna put the pasta in there. You're just gonna, once you put it in there, just put it.
Give it a little stir. This is such a colorful dish.
Yeah, that's I think that the pasta primavera has to be colorful.
I would think so.
You're dealing with pasta. Okay.
We're going the whole pound.
Bam. Okay. So we just throw them in there, okay? I think I need a little yellow. Yeah, that's my girl. So you want to tell me when that's perfect, that pasta, and then I'll strain it? Okay.
Stay tuned for more from Nordon Preferred Kitchen Equipment.
This is my first time at Nordon, and it's been an absolutely incredible experience. The equipment is top notch from the induction burners to this. I mean, this stove gave up off incredible heat, but wasn't hot to me. This deck oven is beautiful. I mean, a plancha. The variety of products that they have is incredible.
Well, you're working on that squash. I'm gonna invite in one of our guests here from Nordon, awesome. Scott Stauffer. How are you?
Oh, good, how are you today?
Great, thanks.
Good.
So,
well, smell the flavors.
That's good.
We have lots happening over here. I hope you came hungry.
I did.
So tell us why chefs should choose Nordon.
Well, the reason is why you should not choose Nordon. Nordon has everything you need. You can design anything you want. We have all the equipment that you need, and we can deliver it, mm-hmm. install it, and give you a wide variety of choices for all the equipment needs that you have.
Fantastic.
So we can do everything and make make all the food that Tony's doing here, make it taste
better.
Yeah.
You guys have an amazing place here. I feel like I'm in Disney World for fat chefs.
You're here. Come around every week. You're testing everything all the time.
So. I'm sure you'd love to have Tony here cooking lunch for the staff.
Yeah, that's
awesome.
Everything's very good.
Thank you.
Fantastic. Well, I hope you join us back at the end. We'll taste together. Thanks, Scott.
Okay, so the asparagus, we're going to go put it in the water
about
1 minute and out. Okay, so we don't want to cook it too much, but we don't want to cook it in the pan. We want to cook it in the water.
Okay.
Just for an even.
Now I'm starting to get just a tiny bit of caramelization on some of these onions.
That's okay.
Should we turn it down?
No, that's perfect. We want some flavor, but we don't want it totally brown.
You're the boss. Just checking.
Holy crap. So we're going to do the broccoli and the cauliflower.
All right.
And we're going to blanch it again. So we're just going to take the heads, okay? And we really make sure these are cooked. If they're too undercooked, they're aggressive. Mm-hmm. If they're too overcooked, they'll be mush and be part of the sauce. And then it takes away the joy of eating them in the pasta.
And a lot of joy they do bring.
We like joy.
We grow great cauliflower in New Jersey.
Oh, really? Yeah, it's the soil.
It is.
Yeah. It's that golden
sandy soil.
Mm-hmm. God touched that area like double touch.
Oh,
I want to make
this
really good. Double touch.
Yep.
You know.
That secret, people from New Jersey. Only we know.
I know. It's a shame. Iowa, being from Iowa, not knowing New Jersey. And how's that doing?
Nice.
Oh, that's perfect, honey. All right, you want to take that out? Sometimes it'll be good like this, baby. No? Yeah, you're right. That's awesome. Okay, we're going to taste the pasta after that. Now, this is the portobello mushroom. It's like the cremini. It's a large cremini. Some people don't like this mushroom.
Why is that?
It's a little, just...
meaty?
Yeah, meaty. I like it. I like all mushrooms.
Pasta is not done yet.
Good. That's what I was hoping. Okay, so I'm going to take these portobello and clean them up a little bit.
Kind of take those gills out?
Yeah.
Yeah, the gills are a little funky.
Yeah.
You know?
They make
weird texture.
Funky. Yeah.
Very spongy.
All right. So we want to look at it. So we're just going to throw this right in the vegetables.
All right.
As is.
Mm-hmm. Nice big chunks.
Yeah, I like it. I think that's part of the fun.
Mm-hmm.
So you're eating the vegetables and it has a lot of flavor into it. If they're too small, Okay. That's good. Check the broccoli.
Not quite there.
No? Okay.
So we know your restaurant food a lot, but what do you like to cook for yourself at home? Stuff like this?
I do.
Mm-hmm.
But I cook for my kids more, they like, as long as they're eating, they're
happy. Gotta get done.
Okay, that's good. We're gonna throw these in there now. Okay, while that's going on. That's beautiful. Now these, we're gonna count 30 seconds.
All right.
Okay.
You could use this water as a vegetable stock after we're done with
it. Yeah, make a soup out of it. Lots of flavor in there. We're 30 seconds, that's all we have to count.
So where I lost count.
You lost count?
I lost count.
So we go start from 10. 10, count
you think?
From 10.
All right.
No, that's good.
Yeah, they're peeling back.
Perfect. Dump them in there. Okay. Put a little cold water in there. Good. Now we're gonna add some heavy cream.
Ooh, now we're talking.
You don't have to add heavy cream in a chicken stock.
Mm-hmm.
I like that.
But why not? You know, you only live once.
Nice.
Got all these vegetables in here anyway. We're already pretty healthy.
Man, you're making me sound good. Okay.
It's easy to do.
Great. Okay, so Well, that's, we're gonna have that come to boil.
Kind of want that to reduce a little.
Right.
And what are you doing here?
I'm going to use the outside of the lemon. I'm going to julienne them.
Mm.
But the white part is very bitter.
Yeah.
And could ruin your dish.
We don't want to do that. We put a lot of hard work into this.
I know. We don't want to ruin that. So you take all this off until we hit the white, the yellow part.
It's a great technique.
Mm-hmm.
Is there an easier way to do this?
Yes, there's a machine.
Okay.
And we're at Nordon, and I should have asked for the machine, but we didn't.
You know
ask
they
for
have
that.
Something for you.
Yeah, they probably do. They're saying,
of course they do. They have everything.
Yeah, they're cursing me out now. This may be my last show in Nordon.
Nah, they like you too much.
I know. Okay, so we do it real thin. And the lemon zest is awesome, is really what makes a primavera.
I can smell it. That's really impressive the way you did that.
Not bad, huh?
You got some great knife skills.
Jesus.
That's really going to brighten this
up,
too.
I might put opera on the way home. You got me pumped up. Okay, let's check this out.
Opera's
here.
Your pump-up music?
No, but maybe now. I'm thinking it might be.
Yeah, it's just all this Italian food.
So we're going to taste it. I think we're close, right?
I think we're close, too.
Mm. That's perfect.
Good?
Mm-hmm.
So you're going to kind of finish it in here?
Put it all in here.
Okay.
Right. Pasta right from right
I'll
here.
I'll let you do it.
There we go.
It's a great stove. It really gets super nice and hot.
So easy. I don't even break a sweat.
That's saying something.
I know. Thank you, sugar. That's Jersey love.
Exactly. That's how we show it.
Yeah, that's how we do it.
We're different.
That this is how we do it. Okay. So we're just going to toss this around, okay? And then I'm going to add some herbs and some tomatoes.
Stay tuned for more from the Chef's Kitchen Restaurant Edition.
Cooking in Nordon is one of my most favorite things that I get to do when I get invited to the show, just because the equipment is so fantastic and they pretty much have everything you could possibly dream of as a chef.
So the tomatoes, we just blanched. And they're pretty much perfect right now. You don't have to cook them. Oops. You don't have to cook them too much. All right. So taste it a little bit. We're not close, but we're getting there.
No, I don't think we put any seasoning into this.
Not yet. No, there's salt in the water and.
True.
Right. And there's pepper in the beginning.
So it's not bad, but it does need some
salt.
Yeah.
So we can put some more in here. If you want to squeeze some lemon in there.
Mmm, that'll be really nice.
Yeah. More pepper in there. Then we have some mint.
Now the mint, that's something really different.
I like it. So we're going to use a little mint and cilantro.
Mm-hmm. What about basil?
Basil's perfect.
So cilantro is definitely not something you would ever see.
Yes. That's my Asian background.
Yeah.
Since I'm not Italian, I can cross that line.
That's pretty fun, though. I can see it working here.
Is it working?
I mean, I can see the cilantro working.
Oh, yeah.
But yeah, the sauce is starting to tighten up really nicely and coat the pasta.
We're not ready yet. Well, the reason why it's coating is to take it right from the water right into there. So the starch is still on.
Right.
You know, so some people, they rinse the pasta before they do it.
Mm-hmm.
That's not good.
Oh, no, never.
I know.
Even an Irishman would make such a mistake.
Well, why do you have to do it like that?
I'm half Irish, too. I'm allowed.
What half?
The not as good half.
Oh, my girl, the bad half. I know. That's how it goes. Okay, so we're looking good with that. You want to toss that pasta, fold it in?
You want to toss it?
I want to
put cheese. Oh, you're going to cheese it. So we did cream and then a little butter, too.
Mm-hmm.
I like where you're at.
Butter, butter, always butter. So good.
This looks awesome. Okay. What a really nice vegetarian name.
What's that, Primavera?
Yeah, I mean, you could serve this to any vegetarian and they'd be happy. Unless they don't eat dairy. But
yeah, well, that could be
that's
a problem.
That's on them. How's it taste?
I love it.
Good.
Clean, fresh, exciting.
Mm-hmm. It is exciting.
You want to try it? Okay. Okay. Then we're going to plate up, and I'll show you how we're going to do that. We're going to
plate up. Pasta's perfect, by the way.
All right, so it's a little heavy.
I'm gonna go home and make this for dinner.
I know, it's so cool, awesome. Okay, so then we turn that off from here. Mm-hmm. So we're gonna take a little pepper on top, because pepper's awesome. Mm-hmm. And we're gonna put a little more cheese on top.
Always more cheese.
Just to make it look like that.
Oh, it smells great.
So then Antonio Quaccarino made a Italian.
Love it.
Awesome.
Let's bring it over.
Fantastic.
Time to taste.
Awesome.
This looks great.
Yeah,
why don't we bring Scott on back?
Okay.
Take a fork. That's for all you. Right. Everybody cheers.
Bon appetit.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers. Oh, I like that.
Yeah, I like to knock forks.
Yeah, stay away from Tony and knives.
No. So this is the fennel, so it's soft and it's nice.
Delicious.
Wow.
Not too shabby, huh?
You taste the vegetable for the vegetable. Mm-hmm. You know, it's not so overcooked. That's
each vegetable tastes like what it is. Mm-hmm. They didn't all meld together.
Yeah, I love that. Mm-hmm. Look at the pepper, perfect.
Wow. Mm-hmm. Appreciate all the different.
And that little bit of lemon
in here.
Yeah.
Really just brings out all the flavor.
Awakens everything.
Yeah. Well, Tony, it's always so nice to have you on the Chef's Kitchen. Thank you for coming out.
Too kind.
Scott, thank you for having us here at Nordon.
It's been good.
It's such a great facility.
Good.
We love being
Thanks
here.
Thanks for coming out.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.